So Damian, in a previous video, you show us, in a previous demo, you show us like how to CI, CD, and deploy to our environment, different environment. But I noticed that there was like a lot of copy paste in your YAML file. So, and I know, you know, copy paste is not the best thing. So is there a way we could improve that?
Yeah, definitely. There's a few ways that you can reduce copy and paste. So, I mean, this is all demo code, obviously, so I'm not doing things exactly the way I would want to do them. One thing that, yeah, you picked up on was the fact that I'm duplicating that for each of the deployments. I'm building my application, I'm packaging it up, and then I'm deploying it to Azure. And really, all of those steps could be in one group of steps. So there are a couple of options available to me. There's, I could write my own action, so my own composite action, and that lets me, you know, build a few different steps together so I can reuse them a little bit later. But there's a new feature that's come out very recently called Reusable Workflows. And I thought I'd show you that as an example of kind of reducing this.
It looked way simpler than coding my own action.
Yeah. And I mean, the composite actions are relatively straightforward and quite similar, but the reusable workflows mean that you can actually just call them from other workflows in a much nicer way rather than having to use, you know, this specific action that I've made somewhere. It's just another thing in your repository that you can call into. So, I'll jump into this. I'm going to come back to, this is the publish YAML file that I showed before. And just to highlight the repetitiveness here, I've got some unique things. So the name of my job and the environment that it's deploying to. But beyond that, it's pretty much the same. I'm choosing that it runs on there. Here are my steps. The steps are all the same. The only thing that's really different is that URL here. The secret is going to be different. And then the slot name is going to be different as well. So there's only a couple of things that are different, and I'm repeating them over here as well for production. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to actually create, or I've already created, a reusable version of this. So this is a little bit different, and I'm going to highlight a couple of them. We saw last time that there were two ways of triggering this release, and we're going to use those same two ways here. So when we publish a new release in GitHub, we'll fire off this workflow and then workflow dispatch. So we're going to do the same thing here, but my steps my jobs are much simpler. There's my staging job, which uses this publish to Azure reusable workflow, passing in a few variables, so a few inputs, and then some secrets as well. So my secret for that environment. And then I'm going to do the same thing in production, passing in the same details, but just for prod. So you can see already that's a little bit shorter. If I was going to do another environment like, you know, pre-prod or something like that, then I just need to reproduce this rather than all of those steps.
And the use where you call that other flow, it needs to be an absolute path?
Yeah, it does at the moment. So it's also qualified by a ref, so a Git ref, basically. So I can choose the branch or a specific commit or a version, for example. So basically, I'm saying, here is the path to the thing that I'm using. Use the one that's this version or the one that's in this branch, for example.
Oh, that's cool.
So this is the caller. So this is the one that's calling that reusable workflow. Let's have a look at the workflow itself, because that's a little bit different too. So let's look at the callee, like the workflow that I'm actually calling. So this is the publish to Azure workflow. And the first thing you'll notice is that the triggers are much more comprehensive. You know, there's a lot more in here. Our trigger is just a workflow call. And what that's saying is this workflow can be called from another workflow. And then I get to define my inputs. So we get a lot of control here. We can define the type of the input, whether it's required or not, default values and description and so on. This just gives you a bit more information when you're calling it. So we're asking for the environment we're deploying to, the URL that it's going to deploy to, the name of the slot, and by default, that's going to be staging. And then we're also specifying that we want a secret called this, and that's required. And then our jobs, we're just doing this once now. So we're deploying to that environment defined by environments. Now, if you remember in our last demo, we had pulled the secrets from that environment, and we've set the process to mean that I have to approve environments. I have to approve a release to production, for example. Mm-hmm. So if this environment name comes through with production, all of this takes effect. So I get that environment protection for whatever environment name I pass in, and I get the variable that I use further down for that environment as well. So I can kind of pass these things through really nicely. And then we just do it once. We just do our deployment to that slot using that secret that we've got from that environment. Now, it ultimately works pretty much the same way. If we just jump back to our actions, we can see we've got our workflows. I'll just zoom out so you can see what it would normally look like. We have our publish to Azure action, which hasn't really been run specifically because I can only call that from another workflow. That's the only trigger I've got. But publish reusable ultimately does exactly the same thing. We can choose where it's going to go, and the UI works exactly the same way. It's just less repetitive. And if I wanted to add another environment, I can easily do that. So exactly the same workflow, just in a nicer way.
Oh, that's awesome. So like if there's something that changed in an environment, or like you something changed, now you don't need to apply those changes everywhere. You just do it once, and then like because of that repetitive structure that you created, like everything will just fall into places. That's cool.
So in my case, I just have a staging and production environment, but I could have a pull request environment for every pull request that comes out, or you know, a one for every branch, and I just have to use that one reusable workflow. And if the process changes for deploying, then I only have to change it in one spot.
Love it, love it. Thank you so much for that demo. And I'm sure we have a lot of questions, so let's join the chat and see what they have.